There's a new biography out of Hank Aaron, the man who beat Babe Ruth's home run record right here in Atlanta in 1974. And he did it without steroids.
Yeah.
Ah, because who needs steroids when you've got virulent racial animosity? That's the Atlanta way. Got us the Olympics. It's interesting. Hank Aaron came one run short of the Babe's record at the end of the 1973 season. He wouldn't be able to break the record until 74. So that was like a six-month gap in which every racist in America could go back to school, gain just enough literacy to write a death threat. Most of them would just cut the words out of whatever reading material was available and pasted it into like a ransom note. Most of it was chewing tobacco labels. So there was a lot of di-u-nicotine. But it just goes to show you the strength of character that Hank Aaron had, you know, because Hank Aaron faced years of increasing racial animosity, right? The closer and closer he got to the Babe's record, the more virulent the threats would get. But still, he summoned up the personal courage to keep getting up to bat and knocking him out of the park. Meanwhile, I've been doing comedy in Atlanta since the 90s. I have never played Uptown Comedy Corner. Not once. Never been. Because I have nothing to prove. That's what I say. I'm not after any records. Unless it's pussiest white guy. I'll take that. That's my beard of bees right there. White guy. I don't need to go to Uptown. I live a mile from here. This is fine. I'll do my annual Dr. King Day set right here. Because the Uptown closes. Hank Aaron went on to run some successful car dealerships. Hank Aaron BMW is still open down there by the south side. You know the least successful car dealership run by an ex-major leaguer? Lou Gehrig Pinto. There was a lot of bad luck on that line.